Internet Marketing and Business Solutions radio show with Ronald Couming, where we help business owners and entrepreneurs attract, convert, and retain their ideal customers and clients by using various internet marketing techniques and methods to achieve even greater success. Today, we are blessed to have in our presence a great, great international speaker, Cami Baker from camibaker.com, author of Mingle to Millions, the Art and Science of Mingling Your Way to Millions, calling in from the West Coast. Cami, how you doing today?
I am fabulous, fierce, and on fire, Ron, and I just want to acknowledge you for this awesome radio show that you've been doing for several months now, almost a year. I've heard some great interviews on here, and I am just honored to be one of them. Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Cami. And I have to let the listeners know, I believe, you know, I've had some tremendous guests, but this is your third time on, and I really, really believe that having such a strong foundation in your business is vitally important, and one of the best ways to grow your business is to learn how to reach out, research, and relationship build, and you are an absolute master at that. So this is your third time on my show, the only one who's been on my show three times, and I find what you have to offer very valuable. We're down to 8 minutes, but I just want to give you the platform to let the listeners know about your big move and whatever else is going on.
Well, Ron, as you know, my book came out a couple of months ago, and I've been doing a lot of touring around. I find myself planted in the Northwest now. I'm looking for more people to share my message with in the Seattle, Tacoma, Portland, Oregon area. What I do is I go in and I speak to any business networking group, entrepreneur group, women's networking group, anyone who has the need and desire to learn how to build business relationships and master referrals and actually have a good time networking. And I use the word networking tongue-in-cheek only because that's what people understand, but I also know that the word networking brings up anxiety and fear and just dread in most people, not you, because you're one of the best networkers I've ever met, but the average person just doesn't want to go network. And I understand that because many years ago when I first started, I didn't enjoy it either. And what I like to tell people is networking does not work because it is random activity. And what I have mastered in my mind is net webbing, which is leveraging planned strategy. And so as you just mentioned, being able to research folks or reach out and relationship build before you even go to an event. You know, imagine friends who are listening, imagine going to these events and not knowing anybody and not knowing who to talk to and what to say and all of those fears and things that I've seen thousands of times at many events. Imagine if you actually learn how to research, reach out, and relationship build so that when you went to events, there were one or two or five people at that event that you'd already spoken to or emailed with, and you're actually excited and looking forward to meeting someone that you know is going to be at the event. So that's just one of the many, many, many tips and strategies and fun techniques that will help people to enjoy going out and building their business as opposed to avoiding it, as I did for many years, sitting in the car looking in the rearview mirror thinking, shit, I'm at another networking event. So let's fix that. I'm on a mission to bridge the humanity gap, as I call it, and just go out and mingle instead of network, because we have to find a place where everything that we do is enjoyable.
Yeah, and I think that's so important, too. And if you go to a networking event, I can remember many, many years ago I joined this big event, and everybody in the room was either a owner of one of the top 225 law firms in Boston, or they were the person who decided the vendors that they would use. And so I joined this group, obviously, for my business because I wanted to start doing some marketing for them. And one of the biggest people in there sat down, and we were just talking. We just sat down by chance at a table. And he said, well, if you're here to make a sale, it's never going to happen. He says, you have to come into this room and just get to know people. And over time, and it might take a year, it might take 2 years, but people have to get to know you, like you, and trust you. And this was, you know, better part of a decade ago, but I can remember this day. I can remember that person, and you know, so and what you're talking about is super important. You can't go in the room, and how you talk about the four personalities, if you're in that room shocking and looking for a contract, you know, day one, it just just a different mindset. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure, and it's such a turnoff. And I love that you said it might take a year or two. And guys, I know everybody wants immediate, instant gratification. We all want to walk in that room and walk out with a $10,000 sale, or somebody joining our business, or a contract that's going to change our lives, and all that. And those do happen. I mean, I've only been to thousands of events, just like Mr. Ron has here, and they do happen. There is immediate business. However, it's really important to understand that, you know, just like any one of us, you know, we want to be able to build a relationship and do business with people we like. And the four different, you refer to them as personalities, and I've heard somebody say that before. Not really personalities. It's more like networking styles. The four personality networking styles that he mentioned are, you know, there's the people who are spraying those cards everywhere, spray, hand a card, you know, pushing a card into people's hands. They're spraying those cards, spraying and praying, and they are repulsing people. I have it happen, and it's so funny. When you really notice these things, you see this person at every event. I can picture the last event I was at in Boston, and the guy that was walking around walked up to a group of four of us, sprayed his card into everyone's hand, never made eye contact, and walked away, and he thinks he's networking. What he's actually doing is repelling, and that spraying is like a skunk, spraying everywhere and repelling. So he's the skunk. And then there's the people who are grabbing the card from everywhere. Hey, you got a card. They're going around grabbing the cards off the desks. They're grabbing the cards out of the little box that's going around the circle. They're squirreling those cards away for a rainy day, and they typically never even call them. And those are the squirrels. And then, as you just mentioned, there's the sharks. Dun, 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 dun. You can see the shark fin on their head. They go around asking, hey, what do you do? And if you don't give them the right answer, they're on to the next person. And the whole time you're talking, their eyes just kind of glaze over because they're not even really listening to you. They're just trying to smell, do I smell any blood in the water? They're just really sharking people and being aggressive and predatory even. And so with the shark and the squirrel and the skunk, guys, I have been every one of them. I have been all of them at the same event. Like, I get it. I see them. I know them. I know who you are, and I've been there. And that's why when you mention that it can take a year or two, here's the blessing of what the spider does. The spider finds a place that she or he wants to create the web. And she makes connections. There's a connection here and a connection there, and these connections start to crisscross, and they get intertwined. And in the life of a spider, it might take 2 hours to do this. In people life, it might take a year or two. But what happens is once that web is created, it is strong, it is interconnected, the connections are strategically planned and placed. And what she does once that's created is she can sit back and wait for that which she wants to come to her. And that's the beauty of creating these relationships and connections, because now I have people just like you, Ron, that bring me referrals every day. Somebody says, hey, Cami, you really need to talk to this person. Hey, this person over here, so-and-so, really needs to talk to you. And sometimes it's about being a client. Most of the times for me, it's about collaboration and getting on a stage, which is what I want to do. I actually really love teaching people how to get on stages in their local marketplace, creating a marketplace in another part of the country, creating marketplaces all over the country if they want it. So yummy. That's a beautiful place to be. So that's what I'm really on a mission to help people understand is stop sharking, stop spraying and praying. Stop squirreling cards away, being a card collector instead of a business builder, and let's step into building that web so that people want to build business with you and you have mastered referrals.
Excellent. Cami, we're coming up on a hard break, and this is just so tremendous. Cami Baker of CamiBaker.com. If you don't know her, you have to know her. Again, CamiBaker.com. Thank you so much, Cami. You've been listening to the Internet Marketing and Business Solutions with Ronald Couming of RCS Technology Solutions. Have a great day, everyone.